constituencies, and I want to understand what they think so that we can design a policy that is fit for purpose, not just for the disruptive businesses, but for the people who are being disrupted. No? And what they did is they had a community developed an artificial intelligence tool called Polis, which basically allowed her to crowdsource input from thousands of Taiwanese people who were giving and sharing information about their concerns, their hopes, their ideas about what these ride-sharing platforms like Uber should actually mean, what they should do, what they shouldn't be allowed to do. And what they did with that is that they went through a lot of information, they got a lot of stakeholder engagement, which they then also coupled with some offline engagement. And at the end, they basically went from opening the consultation to 3 months later passing a regulation through Parliament for new Uber regulation. And what they chose is A, that policymakers can work in a more disruptive way if they let technology also disrupt their own process, not using new digital tools to engage different stakeholders in the consultation process. But B, it also means that you can really shorten the amount of time that it takes to design certain policies. And this is particularly relevant for all of us here, because in the morning we talked about how much we struggle with the very overblown bureaucratic political and policy process. And if we can also help policymakers be a bit braver with how they design policies and how they get input on disruption and what it means to regulate disruption, then we can hopefully design policies that are more fit for purpose for the businesses, but also for the societies that, and the consumers who are using these businesses.
Thank you.